No. All right, we're going to go for now g of 2. And we need a lot more space here. So here we go, g of 2. All you're doing is putting in 2 wherever you see x. So I see x plus 1, which is 2 plus 1 over 2 plus 2. And we got 3/4 for g of 2. So again, our input was x, and the output would be a y value if I was looking at the graph. But I'm looking at an equation of a function, not a graph of a function. So the next we're going to do is solve g of x equals 2. So I'm just going to take the g of x definition at the top right here, x plus 1 over x plus 2, and write that in place of g of x. So I want you to test your algebra skills and tell me what x is. There should be exactly one correct answer here. And your first step, because fractions suck, multiply by the denominator. Get out of fraction land. So this is just a linear equation. We multiply. The right side becomes 2x plus 4 equals x plus 1. Now all you want to do is combine like terms here. So subtract x to the right. We're going to subtract 4. Subtract 4 from the other side. X equals negative 3. So there's your x value, and that is what we were trying to solve for. So in the original right up here, it said solve. Now, the thing we were solving for was the x right there. That was the only unknown in that equation. So any questions on that algebra, getting out of the fraction? All right, last up. I asked for intercepts, which is solve g of x equals 0, and what is g of 0? So we're in the first one. That means we're setting y equal to 0. And what are we looking for when we set y equal to 0? What type of intercepts?
X.
X-axis. So in the first part, we're doing x-intercepts. And so the second part, we're looking for y-intercepts. We're setting the other coordinate x to 0. So go ahead and figure out both of those. There may be more than one solution, but there should be at least one solution for each of these. So our x-intercept should be negative 1, comma 0. And your y-intercept is 0, comma 1 half. So any questions on x, y-intercept? So that was using functions on a graph versus written down as an equation. And we found intercepts, plugged in values, whether they're given an x, find a y, or given a y, find an x. So now we're going to look at some more geometric properties of the graphs. And we're going to look at even and odd. So these are called symmetry. So before we talk about even and odd, I want to talk about why we never have x-axis symmetry with functions. So there's one simple reason we do not have it. Let's say we have a point up here. It doesn't really matter about the x-coordinate, but I want to make sure if you have a point where your y-coordinate is greater than 0, and you have x-axis symmetry, what other point would this graph have to have if this was a graph with x-axis symmetry?
X negative y.
So I'd also have to have x negative y. Why would this, just right here, this fails to be a function? Even before I add any other points. Because we failed the vertical line test, or we have two points with the same x-coordinate, but two separate y-coordinates. So even the simplest graph with x-axis symmetry would fail to be a function. Functions could have, only y-axis, origin, or neither. Okay. So you're not, there is one function with x-axis symmetry. So I should write the word almost. What kind of a graph of a function would have x-axis symmetry? Where would all the points have to be? Well, we could have a point on the origin.
On the x-axis.
So, the only function with x-axis symmetry is f of x equals 0. It's a very boring function.